Police believe there were several people involved, in part because of how they broke into the school. They believe they took picnic tables here, moved them against the wall, stacked them up, and then got in through a second-story window.
It may look like overkill to surround the Russell Elementary School with crime scene tape until you get a look inside. There is paint splashed on walls, ceilings, floors. Nothing, it seems, was spared. The police chief says he doesn't know how someone could do this.
It appears that it's kids, and you wonder what we have missed that would lead a kid or kids to do this.
The gym floor is coated with powder from spent fire extinguishers. It was that powder that set off the fire alarm around 4:15 Monday morning. When firefighters arrived, that's when they found the vandalism. The chief thinks the vandals broke in Sunday night or Monday morning, but at this point, they're not sure what ages they're dealing with.
We've created scenarios that we thought it could be from anywhere from middle school kids to kids just graduated high school.
The vandals did leave something behind in addition to the destruction, footprints, which state police are trying to match. The chief says that some of the symbols they used might also lead to their capture.
Hopefully somebody might recognize that pattern. I don't think the person who actually did that was their first time.
The chief estimates that at least $10,000 worth of damages was done. He says whoever did this really struck a blow at Rumney.
We have town meetings here. We have community functions here. It really is the center of our community.
As for what's next?
You pick yourself up, clean up, and you learn from it and move on.
Police believe once they had completed the vandalism, they left out this door and fled down towards the woods. A state police canine tracked them as far as the power lines, where they were then lost. If you have any information, you're being asked to contact the Rumney Police Department or state police. In Rumney, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.